Hello, beautiful Aquarius. How are you today? Welcome to the channel. My name is Donna. This is Irish Donna Tarot. Is it a fling or is it the real thing? That is the question of the day. So let's see what we have. The tribe. So the person that you're involved with, we're looking only at their thoughts, feelings, intentions, and actions towards you. We are not looking at you at this time. So we see that this person is part of a tribe. They have very close-knit associations and relationships with others. So part of the energy is that when they look at you, they are looking to see if you would fit into their tribe. Go the distance. I like it. That is a great card. It is all about pursuit. It's all about, you know, very clearly going the distance. A leg up. This is a person who expects to have a mutual relationship of helping one another. I like it. Okay. So let's take a look for our Aquarius friends at their thoughts, feelings, intentions, and actions. And we're going to cut the deck. Okay, here we go. So this is going to be their thoughts. Okay. Their feelings. Their intentions, and then their actions. Okay. Nice. Okay. I like it. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and clarify also as we go. So we see the Sun card. So they think that you are a bright spot in their life. They feel that they think of you as happiness, pure happiness. You embody a bright, light spirit. You embody somebody who's intelligent and fun and fast, and you're hot. You know, the Sun card is Leo energy. It's about romance. They think that you're very exotic, sort of comes up, but I don't think of the Sun as exotic. They just think that you glow and you shine very, very brightly, Aquarius. Look at that energy. They see you as quite unusual, and you are. They like something about your hair. We also get the Five of Cups energy, so this person definitely feels as though they could have done something that has upset the energy in your relationship. They're feeling very sad about it, and we also see them with the Judgment card. They feel as though it's a call to action, that they need to make a decision. When we look at their feelings for you, the World card says that they think the world of you. They feel that you are a very powerful entity. They also feel in their heart space that they're very curious about you. We have, I call this the Curious George card. It is a card of the Page of Wands, throwing caution to the winds. So for many of you, this is probably a fairly new relationship that has a potential to grow and go the distance. When we get the Eight of Swords, they are locking their emotions behind these sort of bars. However, the cage is open. When the time is appropriate, they will let their emotions out. I do like the guardian angel here. It's a beautiful energy that really speaks to the fact that you are protected and they are protected. This person might have also gone through a divorce or heartbreak in the recent past. It could even be the Judgment of divorce. But when they think of you, they think of you as a new cycle, a new beginning that could be very happy, very successful. They're really watching you very closely. Again, holding back. When we look at their intentions, they are watching you from a distance, and they seem, you know, this is like the Two of Swords. They pretend they can't see you. And the whole time they have this very charming bird's nest and so forth on their head. The King of Wands energy is very passionate energy. They do intend to approach you in a softer way, not to sort of bowl you over. They want to be very tuned in, tapped into your energy. The Queen of Swords, their intention is to look at the relationship, to see if you can go the distance, to judge whether you can go the distance. The Queen of Swords, as we all know, is a very, very, it's Libra energy, and this is a person who does not really suffer fools. You know, this is a person who's serious about love, and they intend to judge the relationship on facts and on evidence of what the relationship can produce. Now, the clarifier, as I was looking at the Queen of Swords, is Ten of Pentacles. So they are looking for someone who with shared values. They very much want to know if you share their values for work, home, finances, family, whatever it is. It's so interesting that that dropped out when I was speaking about that card. The Ten of Pentacles repeats itself here in terms of their actions. They are looking for a relationship with somebody who's single, that's you. Single, ready to mingle, but very content. This is how they see you, and they see themselves as a Ten of Pentacles. So right now, again, I feel as though they're in a period of mourning or sadness that they're coming out of. Your person definitely does not know right now how much interest you have in them, but they intend to go the distance with you. So I would say this is definitely the real thing. And let's clarify and see what else we can learn about this person. Why is the Sun card here? The Emperor card, somebody who wants to step up with authority. That's Aries energy, and we have Leo energy. This is a person who's going to try to make all the right moves, who's going to be playing it cool, but very, very invested in this connection. Why is the Five of Cups here? Yes, this person's moving away from a time in their lives when they were very sad, a very difficult period of time. The Judgment card says that they were leaving a toxic situation. And that they don't want to return to that. This is a person who released someone because of the toxicity in a relationship. Somebody tried to control them, or, you know, it was a really difficult time. So in terms of their feelings, look at that. They see you as a potential long-term lover, somebody that they think the world of. That is Gemini energy and Aquarius energy. They feel as though they want to look into your eyes. They want to make love. We have all this red passion. And the Lover's card is a card that is making a decision about commitment. It's a card that indicates that, you know, you're making a final choice. When we look at the Page of Wands card, the energy is certainly, is this person is looking at you, and they're trying to use their heart to discern how invested you are in relationships and if you will invest in them. They're very worried. They have some fears in their heart space that you may rebuff them. You may not really see them as being as attractive as they hope they are. And when we look at how they're holding back on their emotions, what we're seeing is they're looking to see if you are grounded, if you're nurturing, if you're a solid person, just in everyday life. They really, really need and love and want that. And so it is one of their top priorities. We do get the Queen of Wands. We get the Two of Swords. This person, la, 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 I'm over here not looking, but I'm actually looking at you. And so it's sort of a coy card. It's a card that indicates they're pretending not to look at you, but they are watching every move you make. They find you incredibly sexy, dynamic, you know, like bossing up. They see you as a powerhouse in your own right. The Wands, the King of Wands energy, yes, this person wants to get to know you, get to know all about you. I like it. This Eight of Coins with the Ten of Coins, that what they're going to learn about you, they're going to really like. We also get this person with Sagittarius energy that is, once again, they want passion, but they want passion only if you can go the distance with them, only if you would qualify to be in their life long term as a partner, preferably married partner. The Eight of Swords says that though they have not revealed their actions yet, they have been holding back for a period of time. We do see Eight of Swords here twice. So this person is holding back from you, but they like what they see from a distance. The beautiful Nine of Pentacles is clarified by the Page of Cups. This person has a crush on you. So that's what we see with that card. It's not, it is a love card, but it's also not yet built a lot of momentum to it. And here we go. There's an offer coming in. This person has been sitting around and, you know, they've been thinking about you. And what we're getting here is the energy of, you know, they're tired of being lonely. You know, they're going to rush in with this Gemini energy. We also have Cancerian energy. We have Virgo twice, three times. The Eight of Wands is Sagittarius. But what we see here is a person who is invested and wants to be invested in the long haul to see if the two of you can work things out. So definitely they have a very set idea about what they need. The cards that indicate their thoughts, feelings, and intentions are the cards of stability, the cards that, you know, represent what they need in relationship, which is a lot of trust, a lot of love, a lot of stability, being on the same page. The King and Queen of, that's both Aries energy. So I like it. So let's see what Wellness Time Oracle says. We have twin flames, yin-yang, balance, union, duality, coupling. You complement each other. Well, that makes sense, right? The Emperor and the Queen of Wands definitely complement each other. Let's get another card. Okay, karmic relationships. This was just flipped over. Feelings of really feeling like you've known this person before. Letting go and loving you. So great energy there. Letting go of their past. It looks like they've been through a rugged period of time and they are in it to win it. It does show that they are focused right now on trying to heal and trying to do shadow work. And that's what I see with this energy. So that is what I have for you, Aquarius. It looks like a great reading. I wish you all the luck. See you soon. Bye-bye.